Message begins right now. Beloved masters, in your mind's eye, however you perceive, envision that you are viewing the earth from a great light ship, and together we, the angelic forces and the multitude of universal light beings, representing our Father, Mother God, are bringing forth the vibrational patterns, the energy and the wondrous divine schematic in preparation for humanity's inhabitation of the earth. During the intricate, complex stages of preparation, great sentient crystals were implanted deep within the earth in strategic places around the planet. A portion of each huge crystal rose from the earth's surface as a sentinel which radiated energy and information out into the cosmos, as well as functioning as a receiver of divine light, wisdom and power from our Father, Mother God. Over the many eons of time, as earth changes took place whereby mountain ranges rose into the skies, land masses sank beneath the waters, and continents shifted and changed shape, most of these great crystals were shattered and buried deep within the earth and the waters. However, many remained intact deep within the waters, in great caverns, and many more lie close to the surface of the land, hidden only by a thin covering of earth or vegetation, waiting for you to discover them and bring forth their powerful gifts and ancient memories. They are the earth's record keepers, and you hold the key which will give you access to the wisdom and the power of manifestation that lies dormant within them. The first great era of Atlantis was a wondrous time of learning to use the qualities, virtues and abilities of your God-given nature on the material plane of existence on the planet Earth. You, as a member of the Atlantean route race, incarnated with the knowledge and ability to bring forth the primal life force substance of creation through the powerful crystals and mold it into many magnificent objects by using your mind power and conscious intention in cooperation with your higher, God Self. Each one of you bears within the essence of your soul, your DNA and your personal God mind such wondrous gifts, such magical energy and a vast memory bank of universal information and history. All of these stories that are now being told and the ancient memories that are being accessed, don't you realize that you were there? Perhaps it was not always specifically you in physical form, but at times it was a close member of your soul family. You do not have to personally experience everything that has happened during this great journey throughout the universe and on Earth to be a part of it or to have it in your memory bank, for you have a lifeline, a soul memory connection with your immediate soul family, which creates a link whereby they will gain the data and wisdom from your experiences, and their experiences are seeded into your memory storehouse as well. You think you are disconnected, you think that you are alone. One of the most important things you have forgotten is that you not only have a beautiful stream of light that comes down from your God ray and pierces your crown chakra and permeates your physical being, a continuous pulsation of divine energy which is your lifeline from and to the Creator. Without it you would not be alive. You could not exist. Know that this column of light is widening and becoming stronger so that more and more divine elixir of life can pour down into and through you as it permeates your body and radiates down into the soul essence of the earth. This rarefied energy is critical for your host planet as this great being struggles to return to balance and harmony within, as well as lessen the intensity of the cataclysms on its surface. And it is especially important in the process of purifying and returning the auric field that surrounds your planet to its original blueprint of perfection. The return to harmony and balance begins within each of you. Unity consciousness can begin with you, here and now, in this moment. First you must acknowledge and bring forth into your consciousness all of those unbalanced fragments that you have created during your many lifetime experiences, those things that control you, those things that have created an emotional and mental prison around you in your auric field. First of all, you must become aware of these fragments and how they affect your reality, and then through your conscious intent you must create a desire to change and to fill those fragments with love, light energy. We are always ready and willing to assist you in your positive endeavors, but you must ask and give us permission so that we can reinforce your resolve, so that we can give you the necessary knowledge along with swiftest and best way to accomplish your transformation with ease and grace. In the past, you have tried many times to stifle or gain power over your addictions, your negative habits and thought patterns. You have resisted them, hated them and constantly thought about them, thereby reinforcing their control over your emotions, your mind and your quality of life. Remember, we have said many times, for it is a universal truth, wherever and whatever you focus your attention on you give energy to and reinforce, whether positive or negative. You must free the fragments you have created by loving them and acknowledging that they have served you well, and by sending forth an impassioned thought that now it is time for them to be reunited and to once more be a part of you within your solar power center of the heart, to be filled with light and to become an empowered facet of your God consciousness. Know that everything, at some level, is seeking the light, is seeking balance and harmony, seeking to return to that which it was in the beginning. Each phase of new awareness or expanded consciousness has its special miracles and benefits which are to be savored and enjoyed. Each time you release some old self-limiting, painful thought form, habit or discordant energies within, you are transformed, and you remove a small, or large, part of your disguise which allows you to integrate another facet of your wondrous God self. In doing so, you are gradually creating a new empowered you, and a new reality opens to you whereby you have access to many new concepts, as well as new talents, and your sensitivity to the exquisite nuances of spirit miraculously unfold around you. If you could truly see the grid system, the web of life or connection of all things, you would have a better understanding of the concept of oneness. It is not just the earth that has an intricate grid system. You have streams of light that radiate forth from you and to you, one to another, back and forth amongst every person on earth, some stronger, some weaker, but you are still intrinsically connected with everyone and everything on your planet and even within this universal expression. This may be mind-boggling and hard for you to imagine, but it is true. When we say you are all one, what does this really mean and how does this happen? It is because there are those streams of light that penetrate and filter through everyone and around and through all of the earth. Yes, most of these streams of light are very weak, but more and more of these streams of light are growing stronger and are setting up a vibration of recognition. There is an echo from within that says, "Yes, I remember you. Yes, I know who you are and I know we have been together before. I don't know where, but I feel and recognize your vibrations and your energy signature. You touch my soul and make my heart strings sing. Your loving essence assures me that I am no longer alone. Welcome into my heart. I ask you to share my journey and to allow me to be a part of your journey as well. You are learning so much so quickly. It is often so mind-expanding that you do not know what to believe, and you think you cannot take in or integrate any more new information, but we tell you this is only the beginning. You are becoming spiritual, human adults, whereas in the past you have been functioning as human children of the world, feeling as though you were disconnected from God and tossed about by the whims of fate and nature. As self-masters and spiritual adults, you are learning that you are citizens of the universe, you are starseeds, light warriors and the vanguard of the new age. You have soared throughout this universe and other universes as well. You have heard that for a very long time there was a quarantine around the earth, this solar system and even your galaxy, which has now been dissolved so that you may receive galactic, cosmic and omniversal information. We now tell you that there was also a filter placed around this universe that is situated at the far which we all are playing an integral part, is one of the most recent universes to be created from the essence of the Supreme Creator, and therefore it is a universe that is situated at the farthest edge of creation. We too have been limited in our knowledge of the workings of the Omniverse, as well as the amount of higher frequency vibrational energy that we have had access to. You see, the first universes that were created were the most powerful and the closest to perfection, for they surrounded the great central sun of the Supreme Creator and contained the pure essence of creation. As more and more universes, galaxies, star systems were created, ever expanding and pushing creation further and further out into the great void, and further away from the Supreme Creator, each refraction into density meant each new creation had less of the power. You must realize that we are all much stepped down energetic fragments, but still an integral facet of the magnificence of the Supreme Creator. And if we were sent forth with the command to create in the Creator's name, for it was the Creator's desire to experience more of itself, why would the Creator tell us what we were to create? We were given a blessed divine gift as co-creators, and so were each of you. You are a co-creator god in your own right, and that is not sacrilegious, it is a universal truth. You must understand that is why you are here on earth, that is who you are. Don't let anyone tell you any different. Remember, you are also responsible for your own creations through the laws of cause and effect. Please understand that this universe was created with dramatically stepped down and diluted primal life force substance. Some are calling this universe a fallen universe, but we do not choose to call it that. This is a universe which was created specifically so that we could experience duality and polarity. The spectrum of light and shadow was designed with the still point of creator light at its center, and the pendulum of duality was to swing only so far into the positive, negative, masculine, feminine, the light, shadow, the yin, yang. You must understand that some of the co-creator gods created less than perfection, as they too learned to use their creator-given rights. Over the eons of time, the pendulum has swung further and further into the shadow land of duality, but it has always been balanced with the same amount of divine light substance. The duality, polarity of the earth is now in the process of returning to center, into its proper, designed spectrum of light, shadow. There have always been magnificent emissaries from the higher realms scattered throughout this universe, and particularly in your galaxy and on the Earth, for this is where the culmination of this divine experiment in creation is being played out in its final stages. As we have told you before, the Supreme Creator is now taking an active role in the creative process of all the Omniverse, and the pure, rarefied energy from IT's heart core is now streaming forth and affecting every facet of itself, from the greatest to the most minuscule. Creation does not contract, it is ever expanding, and you have an integral part to play in that expansion. Each of you is the center of your own universe. You, as a co-creator, send out energy and intent which creates thought patterns of a certain frequency which go forth from you as rays of energy in an infinity sign. These pulsations go out in every direction, creating waveforms which are a reflection of your conscious thoughts, intent and actions. As you learn to stay heart-centered and radiate unconditional love and balanced, harmonious vibrational patterns, your world and reality change dramatically. For you are functioning as an empowered master of co-creation, a true divine emissary of our Father, Mother God and the Supreme Creator. During these times of uncertainty and great change, remember, my beloved warriors of light, there is nothing to fear and so very much to be gained. Feel the warmth of our sacred breath as it brushes your cheek, sense the aura of love in which we surround you. We are near. Reach out and touch us. We will respond. You are loved most profoundly. I am Archangel Michael. End of the message. Much love to all you soul sisters, brothers. Watch my previous videos for better understanding. New subscribers will be updated with the latest articles and informations. We hope this channel has helped you discover where to start on your actual spiritual path. It's a good karma to put to like, comment, subscribe and share with your beloved ones. Leave your suggestion in the field below. All the love to you, beautiful souls.